Good morning. Welcome back. The last 2 days, we heard about solar wind measuring technique, and yesterday we saw some results of three-dimensional solar wind, how the solar wind changes with the source region on the surface of the sun. And today we will be starting the talk now on coronal mass ejection and core rotating interaction region. So in this talk we will discuss some basics about the coronal mass ejection initiation, and then how they propagate in the interplanetary medium. Mostly we have information about coronal mass ejection structure, speed and density variation from the near sun region to the near earth orbit. So we will be seeing the basic properties of coronal mass ejection, and we will also see the some properties of core-rotating interaction region. So the outline of my talk and the presentation is going like this: coronal mass ejection with an introduction and the propagation and the evolution in the sun-earth distance, or we can say inner heliosphere, and some of the snapshot images of the coronal mass ejection in the near sun region as well as in the interplanetary medium, and properties at the near earth space. We will see core rotating interaction, and then we will see briefly about the evolution characteristics and their properties at about ONU and beyond. And we will try to summarize. For coronal mass ejection, we have a summary, and as well as for core rotating interaction region, we will have a summary. Okay. Coronal mass ejection is a significantly large cloud of solar plasma, and it also accompanies solar magnetic field thrown into the interplanetary medium or thrown into the solar wind. The ambient solar wind get disturbed because of this kind of transient event. Generally, fast coronal mass ejection, they occur at active regions of highly twisted magnetic field or highly stressed magnetic field configuration. Sometimes coronal mass ejection can also occur due to eruption of filament prominent, that is the magnetic flux rope thrown into the interplanetary medium, flux rope like filament are prominent, and they are from the cool dense region of the solar magnetic structure. Mostly CMEs are accompanied by flux rope structures also. CME propagating faster than the ambient solar wind can generate shocks in the interplanetary medium. So they tend to pile up plasma on the way to Earth or beyond, and then shocks are produced. The important properties considered for CMEs are CME speed, where they are high speed CMEs or normal speed CME, and their size, whether they are partial halo or narrow CME. Partial halo and halo CME, they tend to fill the large space of the interplanetary medium. And then the direction, whether they are directed along the sun earth line or they go away from the sun earth line, these are really important characteristics considered CME impact in the near earth space. So at the earth space, the associated shock plays an important role when the shock hit the earth magnetosphere. So that can cause a lot of disturbances. And the magnetic field associated with the CME, the magnetic field can reconnect with the earth magnetic field to pump high energy particle and cause magnetic disturbances. So these are all the general description of CME. And then the important aspects of the birthplace on the sun, whether they are initiated at the highly twisted or highly stressed magnetic field. Sometimes they are all called delta configuration. So the magnetic field configuration is highly stressed or highly twisted. So they can throw away strong flare associated CME, and they can also cause particle acceleration in the interplanetary space. So this gives a cartoon of magnetic activity with the north pole and south pole. So we see magnetic configuration due to the footfall in motion. These magnetic field can evolve, and then due to the photospheric motion, they come closer and then they reconnect. So the reconnection process can lead to the ejection of plasma as well as the magnetic field into the interplanetary medium. So reconnection site or in the current sheet, how big is the current sheet during the reconnection? We do not know actually. So that should be a very, very small length scale. But the reconnection, if the strong reconnection is there, at the reconnection point or during the reconnection, we get whole range of electromagnetic spectrum emission actually. So for example, this cartoon by Kopp and Newman and Yokoyama and Shibata-san, actually this gives the typical reconnection site. Okay, so this is the plasmoid ejected into the interplanetary medium, and then here the shock is formed, and then this is the X point this is the reconnection jet can also take place. So these two put points can be sometime observed in hard X-ray high frequency observation. So they represent the foot point of this gives the simple minded picture for reconnection, but the reconnection happening can be in a very very complex magnetic configuration. Complex means it may have quarter pole or lot of polarity may be there in the magnetic configuration. So this is the typical. So to give a picture of reconnection, these two pictures have been given. Okay. So at the reconnection site, the flux row, and this gives the H alpha ribbon or H alpha opposite polarity line. So above that, the flux rope can be there. This flux rope can get ejected after the reconnection happens. So this can cause the pile up of material around that. So the in front of the piled material, we can see the shock also. So this gives a schematic diagram for coronal mass ejection initiation. So this picture has been taken from Forbes review paper. So for example, I will give an example of a coronal mass ejection region. So this mass ejection was a very intense mass ejection which occurred on 13 December 2006. It caused range of impacts in the near earth space as well as in the interplanetary medium. So this occurred at the active region AR, which was close to the central meridian, south 6 and west 23. So this was the active region picture, and this 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 active region produced a number of plates actually. So here in the top panel we see the x-ray, soft x-ray flux at 2 wavelength at 8 angstrom and 4 angstrom. So the all the peaks corresponds to x-ray plates. So it caused a large number of x-ray plates. And then this middle panel, this panel shows the particle associated with these layer and the CME. So huge particle events actually at energies of the order of 100 MeV to something like 1 MeV, huge particle acceleration took place. So this 13th December, this was the particle profile. So this was the arrival of the shock at the near Earth space. The particle profile also, we can see the arrival of the shock. So this gives the magnetic configuration associated with it. This is this one gives the neutron monitoring data. So this 13th December was associated with the GLE, ground level enhancement event, and then it was followed by a foremost decrease also. So this for several days, how the active region behaved, we see that. So the active region, this is the configuration of active region. In fact, this is a zip animated movie. So this in this active region, these two sunspot, they were rotating with each other. So during the rotation, the magnetic stress or magnetic twist increased enormously, and then it's like a twisting of a rubber band. If you keep on twisting the rubber band, when it reaches the threshold, rubber band can break and then get thrown into the air like that. So the twisting of magnetic field and the because of the rotation, the magnetic field got twisted and stressed, and then the coronal mass ejection occurred. So this shows the two active region. The coronal mass ejection occurred from this region. Actually, there is a movie of this this mass ejection, which was taken by Kinode spacecraft, which is solar, the Japanese mission. This is also a magnetic measurement from the Kinode spacecraft. So this mass ejection was huge in speed actually. So we saw coronal mass ejection coming out of the corona. This is LASCO C2 coronagraph, LASCO C3 coronagraph. In the C3 coronagraph, we see snow filled with the whole of the coronagraph, because along with the mass ejection, the high energy particle or SEP, solar energetic particle event also occurred that hit the coronagraph aperture, and then they caused the snowing actually. So sometimes the particle, even if they are very strong, they can reduce the sensitivity of the coronagraph also, because the contrast decreases, so it makes difficulty in figuring out the CME. Okay, so this was the CME associated with this player CME event. And then there is another interesting CME event, which originated close to the central meridian at north 22 and west 7 solar location. It was associated with the X 5.7 and 3B player actually. For example, the previous event was an X class 3-level player and 4B in optical player. So this X class player and X class, M class, and C class, they are representing the energy level of the player actually. As we go from lower to higher energy, we get from A, B, C, M, and X class player. So the X class players, normally they represent the strongest player, or one can say the most of the time the fast CME or energetic CMEs are associated with the intense player. So this was the X six player. So this was this picture shows the alpha image thing with three 236 mats, radio contour, and this below this radio contour, this flux row was located. It got ejected from the Bastille Day event or July 14th event. So this event caused a huge energetic particle. So when the flare took place, we could follow the blobs associated with the ejection in radio radio imaging plots. So this radio image is from NASA radio heliograph at 164 mats. So the NASA radio heliograph gave 164, 236, and 410 mats. So we could follow the radio blobs or the blobs associated with the CME in a couple of wavelengths. And then this caused a halo CME. The CME was symmetrical with respect to the center of the sun. So this filled the nearly the whole of C2 field of view. Okay, so this is the C3 field of view. So here also we see the snowing effect actually. The particle hitting the coronagraph aperture, they cause the charge. So this actually it was very difficult to separate the particle noise in analyzing the CME event. So this caused a huge radio eruption in meter wavelength. And in 1 mats to 13 mats, this is a wind wave spacecraft. We saw an intense radio emission. So in the interplanetary medium, we could track this CME, because this CME was propagating. In the initial speed was something like 1,500 to 2,000 kilometer. And then in the nearer space, the CME speed was about 1,000 kilometer. In between sun and earth, interplanetary scintillation observation from Ooty gave the images of the CME. This is 15th July, and then 15th July evening, this was the CME structure. You can see the CME here moving out actually. So this CME could be followed using several ground-based instrument, remote sensing technique, as well as spacecraft observation. So this CME gave a nice speed profile from sun to earth distance. We will be seeing it. So the energy accumulated over a long period, okay, for example, in the twisted magnetic field configuration, energy is getting accumulated as the foot points moves randomly. The magnetic field get twisted or getting tangled. So that increases the twist as well as the stress in the magnetic field. So the energy accumulation can take place over hours or days or sometimes several days also. So as it get accumulated, the magnetic field become tense. So they erupt. The reconnection cause the eruption. But the releasing of the energy, the magnetic field, twisted magnetic field, stored accumulated magnetic field, releases the energy within a short time scale, within some couple of minutes to something like within 10 minutes, or within sometimes the flare can be less than 10 minutes, or it can be something like 30 minutes. So within short time, the energy accumulated over a long period, it is getting ejected or getting released in a short time. So the energy release can be huge actually. Normally CME kinetic energy involves, so which is decided with the mass and the velocity, it can be average is something like 5 to 10 to the power of 30 Hertz or so. That's the average. So some CME can have a order of or two orders of magnitude higher than this kind of average kinetic energy. So the magnetic energy is converted to thermal energy, also radiative energy absorbed over a large part of the electromagnetic spectrum. Some CME can be associated with the gamma rays and X-rays and the high energy particle, maybe several tens of MeV to 10 MeV or so. So high energy particle and the hard X-ray, and then the radiation can go up to radio wavelength also. So the kinetic energy release is associated with the mass release and the energetic particle. Okay. So this shows the profile of X-ray and the meter wavelength and the decameter and the electric wavelength range actually. So this CME has been seen in all electromagnetic spectrum from X-ray to something like kilohertz range. So this part is missing. Expanded and shown in this plot. So the CME, they not only involve ejection of material, magnetic field, they also involve high energy particle acceleration, they also associated with the huge ejection of or huge radiation part of the electromagnetic spectrum. This slide shows some of the snapshot images of several CMEs. So you can see this is the in the coronagraph. The circle represents the solar disk. This is the coronagraph disk. This is artificially eclipsed disk, and then you can see the because coronal mass ejection, they are huge, they are energetic. But their intensity when compared to the solar disk intensity is very, very small actually. So for example, we can see the corona during eclipse only. So like that, we are making artificial coronagraph to see the mass ejection. So here you can see in C3 field of view, you see the mass ejection. So the important point is, look, one can track the leading edge. So time and the leading edge position, okay, can give the velocity of the CME in C2 field of view and C3 field of view. C2 can go up to something like 2.2 solar radii to 6 solar radii, and then C3 can go up to something 4 solar radii to 30 solar radii. So within 30 solar radii, coronagraphs are useful to track CME structure as well as the speed. So these are all the some CME. So in this we see all CMEs are associated with the flux flow. So you can see that in some cases even shocks can be seen in the coronagraph picture. Okay, so now let us summarize the CME property. Largest phenomena associated with the dissipation of magnetic flux at and above the surface of the sun. Ejection of large scale as well as organized coronal structure escaping into the interplanetary medium or heliosphere. CME involved ejection of something like 10 to the power of 14 to 10 to the power of 15 grams of material. It's a huge, actually. Okay, huge with the magnetic field. Okay, so CME can travel something like a few tens of kilometers to a few thousands of kilometers also. Width can be something like 40 degree width in this thing. Coronagraph field of view, the width of the CME can be something like 40 degree to 360 degree. It can fill the whole field of view. So 360 degree means we call it as a halo CME, and then sometimes it can be partial halo. Partial halo means most of the coronagraph field of view may be covered. Generally, fast CMEs are associated with flares, and slow CMEs are associated with filament or prominence eruption. CME can accelerate energetic quantity. Okay, in the interplanetary medium, as the CME propagates, so energetic particle acceleration can take place. The huge CME, when they engulf the Earth, or the huge CME, when they fill the heliosphere, they can shield the galactic cosmic ray. So that phenomena is known as the Porthos degree. So tomorrow we will see some of the effects of CME in the near Earth space. So, but let us keep it in mind that it can shield against the galactic cosmic rays. So they are known as Forbes decays. The important bottom line, the CMEs are the main cause of strong or intense geomagnetic storm. So that we should keep in mind. Okay. So the radial evolution, that's a very, because there are a lot of interest in understanding the evolution of CME, as well as in predicting the CME at the near Earth stage. Lot of research or lot of solar physicists, they try to predict the CME arrival. So what are all the important parameters required to predict the CME? So one should know the direction, one should know the velocity, size, and how the velocity is evolving. So we try to observe CME with 2 to 30 solar radii using GLASCO and 20 to 250 solar radii using interplanetary simulation method. Okay. So this CME we saw, this is the Bastille Day event. The CME could be tracked in the 30 solar radii region using LASCO white light images, and this low frequency spectrum, something like 1 to 10, 13 MHz, could give the information about propagating type 3, and this IPS images gave information about something like 50 solar radii to 30 solar radii to 250 solar radii. So this gives the high time plot. This is the y axis is the height, the x axis is the time. As we go, this is from the LASCO, this is from the radio bus. These points are from IPS and near Earth spacecraft. So we could track the CME all the way from sun to Earth distance. So when we have dr by dt, if we take, so that gives the velocity as a function of distance from the sun. So we could see the velocity of the CME slowly, gradually decreasing, and started decelerating rather fast at about starting from 100 solar radii. So this gave the first evidence that the CME speed profile can have a two-step deceleration. Okay. So for example, if you see from near sun region to about 100 solar radii, the radial profile was very shallow, actually. That's crazy. So here after that, it decreases rather fast, actually, out of the power of point minus 7. R to the power of minus 0.7, here is R to the power of 0.1, something like that. So this involves dissipation of energy within about 100 solar radii of 10 to the power 32 Earth. So this accounts for dissipation of kinetic energy of the order of 10 to the power 32 Earth, actually. So the initial kinetic energy could have been very large. So that indicates the dissipation. Whereas in this region, again, the dissipation is also larger than this, actually. So this indicates that CME can have evolving speed profile in the sun at the distance. Okay. So this was an interesting event. So you can see the CME evolution in the, so because CME originated in the west limb of the sun, so this gives the CME at about 50 solar radii, 100 solar radii, 150 solar radii, and 200 solar radii. So one can see the expansion of the CME. The CME expansion goes as r to the power of 1. As r increases, or as the heliocentric distance increases, the CME size also increases. So this is typically goes as r to the power of 1. So that indicates that the CME tries to maintain the pressure balance between the driving gas and the ambient solar wind. So the bottom line is CME is trying to maintain the pressure balance between the CME driving gas and the ambient solar wind. So that's the important indication. So that gave a speed profile order of 0.8. So this CME was also a very intense CME. So if we see the CME profile, this is for three different CME, some CME speed decreases rather slowly, some CME, for example, this CME went from 1000 kilometers, something like 800 kilometers. This is near sun, this is the near earth. So some CME starts with something like 800 kilometer, and the near earth space, it was about 450 kilometer, whereas this CME increased and then decreased. So we see a zoo of radial evolution of speed. This is an interesting CME. This CME was not associated with the flare. This CME was associated with the prominent or filament eruption. So this gives the high time plot. This is from Moscow. This is from IPS measurement. So the nice high time plot, when we take the derivative of the time derivative of the height plot, we get the speed. So this CME started from at about something like 20 kilometer per second, and then attained the speed of about something like 700-800 kilometer in the nearer space. So that's amazing. This CME is continuously accelerating. For example, if you put a wood in the river, the wood speed cannot be greater than the river speed, actually. So when you put a CME into the interplanetary medium, into the solar wind, the solar wind can carry the CME at its speed. So if the solar wind speed is something like 400 kilometer, CME can maximum attain the 400 kilometer speed. But here we see the CME speed has increased more than the ambient solar wind. So there is some driving mechanism within the CME to accelerate or to support the propagation. So that finding came from several directions also. This is for a particular CME, and then here we see actually this is this CME, this profile, this is the distance, okay, something like 2 solar radii to 215 solar radii, and then this CME speed is something like 300 kilometer. It is something like 2500 kilometer. So we get low speed CME, they get accelerated. So this could be because of the CME is carried or CME is accelerated by the ambient solar wind. So some CME they propagate at constant speed. Some CME they rather gradually accelerate, but high speed CME they decelerate very fast or very rapidly. So this is the log plot. So that indicates the typical propagation properties of the CME. So this indicates that the ambient solar wind plays a major role. So this gives the drag force acting on the sun. The drag experienced by the CME in the ambient solar wind seems to play a significant role in shaping the CME speed profile. So that's the important bottom line to be understand actually. So the CME speed profile is mainly shaped by the ambient solar wind, because the ambient solar wind applies the drag to the propagating CME. This has been studied by several authors, Gopalswamy, Manogaran, Kargil, Vasanak, and Gonzalez, Lara, Lindsay et al. However, the magnetic energy is likely to support the propagation. How much it can support? Let us see some part actually. Okay. That is the question.
General question. What is the pressure level of CME to maintain to itself?
No, the pressure level is okay. There is a question. I will come to the question in the latter part. So this shows, this plot shows, this is the speed, CME initial speed. This is the deceleration after about 70 solar radians. This is the deceleration or deceleration slope. So we could see that for slow speed CME or some CME speed of the order of 500 to 1000 or 1500, the slope is small. Whereas the high speed CME, the slope is rather steep actually. So the sloping or decreasing of CME speed with the distance from the sun or at distance greater than 70 solar radii depends on the initial speed. So this line indicates the zero acceleration line. So these CMEs, for example, these four cases, they have been accelerated in the interplanetary medium. This plot, the inner plot, shows the slope multiplied by the energy given to the interplanetary medium, or the energy lost or dissipated in the ambient solar beam is directly proportional to the speed difference between the CME and the ambient. This plot gives a overview that most of the CME energy is dissipated in the solar beam. Solar beam is gaining sometime energy, or solar wind is losing sometime energy to the CME or gaining from the CME. So that is the major factor in deciding the CME speed proper. Again, this gives the 1 AU speed of the CME, that's the magnetic cloud or ejector speed, and then this is the initial speed. So there seems to be a trend actually. So this curve gives the initial speed and the final speed, they are same, then all the CME should be on this line, but this is not the case. Except few CME, they get accelerated, all the CME they get decelerated. So again, so this gives the initial speed as a function of final speed, and this is an important plot. This gives the CME initial speed and then the travel time for the CME. So the travel time decreases for high speed CME, but does it decrease considerably, or does it, for example, if you take a 500 kilometer per second CME and 2000 kilometer per second CME, does it increases four times? No, that's not the case actually. So that there is a trend, but the travel time can have a large scatter also. The one important point in this plot is this is the fitted curve. For 400 kilometer per second CME, the CME travel time is 90 hours. For example, 400 kilometer per second solar wind will take more than 100 hours. Oh, that indicates that 90 hours is more than 10 to 14 hours difference is there for 400 kilometers per second CME versus the 400 kilometers per second solar wind. So that indicates that CME has an internal energy. So this is the inference we get, that CME internal energy can support the propagation. Okay, that's it. So this plot shows the CME speed in the near sun region in the Lascaux field of view, CME speed at about 0.5 AU, 100 solar radii distance, and then CME speed at 1 AU. So you can see here the large spread gets narrow and it becomes much narrower So this indicates how the CME speed is getting decelerated. This is the short speed of the ODIU part CME. Okay. So again, the near sun speed, it's a wide spread in speed, whereas CME speed at 1 AU, it's a narrow spread. Okay, so that indicates that most of the CME are dragged in the interplanetary medium or in the solar medium. So this shows the what is the typical properties of the CME. For example, in this period 21 to 27 June, this was recently published in a paper by Nogren et al. So in this period, several CME occurred. Though we observed 6 shocks in the interplanetary medium or at 1 AU. So all this is the magnetic field. The sudden discontinuity indicates the shock. Sudden discontinuity in magnetic field, velocity and density, and the temperature, they can indicate the shock. So 6 shocks were introduced. So this is the temperature. This is the 10 MeV particle. So all these CMEs were associated with the energetic particle. And but not all the shocks were associated with the geomagnetic storm at the Earth magnetosphere. Okay, one CME caused a huge shock actually at the huge geomagnetic disturbance at the nearest scale. So again, this is the same plot. Okay, here instead of geomagnetic index, we have included the galactic cosmic ray count. So this CME caused the fourth cosmic ray. So this is the one CME. This is the other CME. This CME is causing the fourth cosmic ray. This CME is causing this one moving out. This causes the fourth cosmic ray. So the CME, when they engulf the Earth, so this here the location of the Earth is somewhere here. Okay. So this is the typical properties of the CME. So in summary, CME size expansion both at out of the power of 1. So CME is trying to maintain the pressure balance between the driver gas and the ambient solar wind. The speed profile, we are source dependent dependence on the initial speed. For given initial speed, whether it is 1,000 kilometers, for 1,000 kilometers, we see variation in travel time. So that indicates the CME propagation medium that plays a major role. So that CME goes through continuous changes with depends on the interaction with the surrounding solar wind. And then the mean travel curve for different initial speeds suggests that up to about 80 solar radii, the internal energy of the CME helps in propagation. After the CME loses its internal energy, then the drag or the solar wind takes over. So that causes the huge decline in speed. Most of the CME tend to attain the speed of ambient flow at 1 AU or further. So some CME attain the ambient solar wind at about 3 AU to 5 AU. Some CME attain the ambient solar wind even within 1 AU. So the CME is possessing a lesser internal energy that allow can decelerate quickly. So these results are useful to quantify drag force imposed on a CME. So this gives the typical summary of the chorotic interaction. Chorotic interaction can be produced when the fast solar wind flow originating from coronal hole interact with the slow wind. So the interaction region, because the fast wind has a nearly straight line magnetic field, slow wind associated with the field more curved than the fast wind. So at some distance, but it's a simple high school mathematics. One can take 300 kilometer, 400 kilometer slow speed wind, and then other high speed wind can be taken as 800 kilometers per second, and then we can compute the physical identifying the location of these two, or can compute the physical interaction height. So we can interact up something like this, 0.58, 1 AU, and beyond. Okay. At the interaction region, the magnetic field gets intensified because of the compression. The magnetic field can get intensified. It can cause amplification. CIR, or the correlated interaction, can be bounded by forward and the reverse arm. In the forward direction, we can see a forward shock, and then in the backward, we can see a reverse shock. So, several CIR can be observed forward as well as reverse shock. For example, this is the SDO picture taken from spaceweatherlive.com. So this picture indicates the mid-latitude or equatorial region coronal hole. This is the equatorial region. So this is a large coronal hole sitting in the equatorial region. For example, this coronal hole will produce high-speed wind, but this edge of the coronal hole, for example, this region will produce low-speed wind. Here again, low-speed wind will be produced. So this low-speed wind originating earlier than the high speed wind. So this wind and this wind, they can interact actually at a distance from the sun. So this shows typical high speed wind spiral structure, and then low speed wind spiral magnetic structure. So they can interact at some spot. Okay. So this shows the interaction. So this is the interaction, this is the high speed wind, this is the low speed wind, this is the interaction region. In the interaction region, so the forward shock and the reverse shock can take place. This shows the plot of solar wind density, speed and temperature. And then this is the magnetic field when the CME is crossing the end. So this is the stream interaction region. So here we see the coronal hole associated solar wind property. Here we see closed field region associated solar wind property. So in the closed field region, we see a low density. In the interaction region, the speed increases. This is the speed due to coronal hole. So the temperature due to coronal hole is high. The temperature due to closed region is low. So we see this in the interaction region. We see a huge fluctuation in the magnetic field. Or the fluctuation you can see the fluctuation is large compared to the mean level of the fluctuation. So magnetic field gets amplified, and also the direction of the magnetic field varies randomly. So this interaction region can cause shocks, and also the interaction region sometimes particle acceleration also can take place. So this case gives the typical time profile associated with the low speed wind, high speed wind, and interaction region. So with the heliocentric distance, interaction becomes stronger. That's the bottom point. As you go away from the sun, as we go higher and higher solar object, the interaction can become stronger. The interaction observed at latitudes away from the solar equator is caused by drifting coronal holes to higher latitude. So as the solar activity increases or decreases, the coronal hole can move from polar region to the equatorial region and to the other polar region. So the interaction seen in higher latitude, they are caused by the drifting coronal hole. The spreading of density enhancement to a higher latitude is consistent with the tilted type of geometry. So that we can see here. So here we see this is the magnetic current sheet. This is for one solar rotation, 0 degree, 360 degree longitude, south pole to north pole. So this is the location of the current sheet. So this region of the hemisphere is dominated by one polarity. This hemisphere is dominated by the other polarity. This corresponds to a coronal hole. This corresponds to a coronal hole. So these two coronal holes are seen as low density structure in interplanetary simulation. This is on the sun. This is midway between sun and earth. That's 0.5 AU. So we observe these two coronal holes at the nearer to space. So high speed wind is seen. This coronal hole structure, this structure was seen for two or more solar radiation. So this red curve and black curve, they correspond to two consecutive solar rotation. So this shows the this is the nearer magnetic disturbances, and this is the geomagnetic index. So whereas, for example, this coronal hole causes the very weak EZ as well as the disturbance, whereas this coronal hole causes the moderate disturbance on the earth. So here this is the velocity associated with the two coronal holes. So this gives a typical signature of the photoelectric interaction region at the near earth. So if you see the so the same plot has been reproduced actually for CR rotation 2013 and 2014, and so this gives the various parameters, sunspot and density and temperature and the speed, and then KP index. That's the geomagnetic for several years actually. So this year, for example, 2003, the geomagnetic index was high, the speed was high. This region was dominated by coronal hole corresponding. So this 2003, this region was dominated by neglected coronal hole. So for that, so IPS image you saw, this is here, this is south pole to north pole. This region was dominated by interaction region. The interaction has caused the increasing density turbulence. So let us see how this this interaction region evolved with the distance of the sun. This is about 75 solar radii from the sun. This is midway between sun and earth. This is 100 solar radii from the sun. So at about 75 solar radii, the interaction starts to form. Actually, at 100 solar radii, the interaction is getting intensified. At 150 solar radii, the interaction becomes more visible. So the interaction increases, or the compression caused by fast solar wind with a slow solar wind, that tends to increase as a function of distance from the sun. This is the typical example. So the correlated interaction is a high pressure region. So they are the high pressure region, high density, and landing. We see a lot of thunderstorm. It's raining heavily. CI is a region of high pressure. It can lead to forward wave, that's the forward shock, as well as the reverse shock. So these waves commonly steepen into forward shock and reverse shock at about 2 AU, sometimes even at about 1 AU also. But that's an open question. Why some CIRs are producing significant compression? Why some CIR, they do not cause significant compression? Because this correlating interaction region, although that have a they have a similar shape, some are, but that's still a open question. Okay, the primary mechanism is by which the solar wind speed difference are reduced with the with the distance is by correlating interaction. Whether it is a CME or fast wind when they interact with the ambient solar wind, or when they interact with the large volume of low solar, low speed solar wind, they tend to transfer energy from CME to the heliosphere, or from high speed wind to heliosphere. So that causes the interaction in with the distance tends to remove the differences between these two. Okay. So we have seen the both CME properties between sun and air, and the CIR properties between sun to air. But the CIR, they are caused in the mostly they are caused in between under the earth distance. Most of the CME they tend to steepen at about 1 AU or further than 1 AU. I would like to acknowledge the active region image provided by the solar monitor. We acknowledge the spacecraft magnetic field image and SOT image and geophysical data report for some of the data and spacecraft data obtained from Omni and the SOHO space mission for EIT and the LASCO images, SDO images from spaceweatherlive.com and ES solar field measurement, and the solar group at the Marshall Space Flight Center provided the magnetic field image and the tomography reconstruction images. So was made using software supplied by the Center for Astrophysics and Space Science at UCSD, and wind waves data, that's particularly radio data and ghost data sets from NOAA. So I like to acknowledge all these things, and also we have used the NASA radio heliograph images. I would like to acknowledge NASA radio.